Hello guys, welcome to the channel again. I, Chandu, welcome you all. Today we are going to discuss the differences between circuit switching versus packet switching versus mesh switching. Now let's take the part. Here in this slide, we have made the four columns. The very first column for the parameters, second would be circuit switching, next will be packet switching, and third is mesh switching. Now, as you know that these are all the circuit switching, packet switching and mesh switching are the switching techniques available for packet forwarding in nowadays networks. Very first parameter, let's take a setup. So in circuit switching, setup is required. We know that the setup is required for transferring a data, but in a packet switching, there is no setup required. In mesh switching also, there is no setup required to transfer the packets from source to destination. Then service oriented. Circuit switching is a connection oriented service switching techniques, and packet switching is a connection less, and mesh switching can be connection less. The path. In circuit switching, there is a dedicated path available. In packet switching, there is no dedicated path. Any packets can travel from any place. In mesh switching, no dedicated path is available also. Route of packets. Packet travel from fixed path. Whatever the setup path is available in circuit switching, from that path only the packets are going to be switched or transfer or travel. But in a packet switching, the one can choose any path randomly as accordingly. In a message switching, it is kind of a variation. Implementation. In circuit switching implemented at the physical layer. Packet switching is implemented at the network layer. And message switching, it is vendor specific or over the both switching techniques, that is circuit switching and the packet switching. It is designed for, the parameter designed for, it was initially designed for voice transfer, that is circuit switching. Packet switching, it was initially designed for the data transfer, and the message switching is specially, as we know that it is vendor specific, vendor can use for any purpose. Approaches. There are two approaches in circuit switching, namely space division switching and time division switching. In terms of the packet switching, there are two approaches too, that is datagram approach and the virtual circuitry approach. In the message switching, it is not applicable. Store and forward. Circuit switching is not a store and forward transmission, whereas packet switching sometimes store and forward, but the message switching is store and forward only. This is what very important, guys. Next, on the basis of reliability, the circuit switching is reliable. As we know, the dedicated path is available, so reliability is more. Packet switching, there is no reliability, but still people are trusting them because the fast service. Message switching, both reliable and unreliable sometimes. Processing. Data is processed and transmitted at the source only. Whenever there is a data need to transfer from source to destination, it is going to be processed at the source only. But in packet switching, data is processed and transmitted not only at the source, but also at the switching stations. But message switching, it is going to be processed at every node because it is going to be stored and forward. So it is wet and check whether the all arrived or not. Order of data. The entire message is received in the order sent by the source in circuit switching. But in the packet switching, the individual packets of the message are received out of order and so need to be reassembled at the destination. But in the message switching, the mixed approach, but mostly ordered approach. Cost, in terms of cost. Circuit switching is costlier than the message switching and the packet switching. Whereas the packet switching, the cost of packet switching is less than circuit switching. It is message switching, it is a middle in between both one. Bandwidth. The circuit switching reserves the full bandwidth in advance because setup is required, so bandwidth is earlier required. In packet switching, it does not reserve the entire bandwidth in advance. The message switching does not reserve the entire bandwidth in advance too. The charges. In the circuit switching, charges depend on the time and distance, what amount of time is required and what distance are. But the packet switching, it depends upon the speed. But in the message switching, it charge is based on the number of bytes and distance. Congestion. Congestion occur for per minute in circuit switching. Whereas in a packet switching, it is less congestion oriented. And message switching, the switching no congestion or very less congestion occurs. Another difference is splitting of data. whenever there is a data need to be sent from source to destination, that data is not going to be split into number of chunks in circuit switching, in packet. But in packet switching, the message is broken into smaller unit known as packets. In message switching, a complete message is passed across the network. Next difference, data information type. Which type of data is going to be passed? So here analog voice or PCM, that is pulse code modulation, is going to be transferred. Used for that data. In packet switching, the packet switching binary type is used. But in the message switching, the computer language like ASCII, Baudot and Morse is going to be used. Example, circuit switching, we can say telephone directly. Packet switching, there will be a frame relay, IP, X25. But in message switching, example will be hope by hope, telex forwarding, and UCP, that is Unix to Unix copy protocol. Memory space in circuit switching, not required because there is no store and forward network. In packet switching also, there is no requirement. But in a message switching, there is absolutely requirement of the memory space. And actually, we can say it is a disk is required to store these messages entirely. That is, disk is required. Message from. In circuit switching, not applicable. The packet switching message in the form of packets. In the form of, and here in the messages, message switching, the message in the form of block. But we can say the concerning circuit switching, the message in the form of, let's say, actual data. Limit. There is a limit on size in circuit switching. In the packet switching, upper limit of the packet, but in the message switching, there is no limit of block. Any type or any size of block can be transferred, can travel from source to destination. Second will be dependency of packets. Yes, there is a dependency, obvious, because everyone follows the order in circuit switching. In packet switching, there is no dependency at all. In the message switching, the dependency can be yes or no. Apart from this, there is a multiplexing scheme. So in circuit switching, circuit multiplexing is used. In packet switching, packet multiplexing shared media access network is used. In message switching, the character or message switching is used. As far as the routing is concerned, routing during the call setup is done. But in a packet switching, it is manual, independent, or dynamic. So routing can be dynamic. But in a message switching, it is going to be manual. Addressing scheme. Hierarchical numbering plan is going to be used in a circuit switching. In packet switching, hierarchical address space is going to be used. But in a message switching, it is going to be geographically addressing is used. Transmission media. Analog and digital data over different transmission media is going to be in a circuit switching. But in a packet switching, is going to be a digital data over different transmission media. In message switching also, a digital data over different transmission media. End terminal can be telephone in circuit switching. In packet switching, it can be computer, workstation, or host. In a message switching, it is going to be a telegraph. And we know that telegraph is a private network, you can say. The application also, the telephone is an application of circuit switching. Packet switching is internet is an example of packet switching. The message switching is a telegram. Telegraph is the example of this message switching, that is private network. For transmission of telegram. Channel sharing, there is no channel sharing in the circuit switching, but in the packet switching, there is a channel sharing, obviously, and message switching also, there is a channel sharing. The delay is more for setup time in the circuit switching, but there is no delay in packet switching. But in message switching also, there is delay, obvious delay in this one. So these are the differences, guys,